Good evening, everyone. So glad that you're here for our second night of spiritual deepening services, and I really am excited about what God's going to do tonight, because the enemy's been throwing anything and everything in our way to stop us from having service. And if he's working that hard, it means God has something really good in store for us. But I did want to let you know a couple of things. One, right now, currently, the water is off. If you didn't notice when you came in, we're trying to water the whole neighborhood over here. I'm not exactly sure what happened, but we had a break on one of our faucets, and water's just gushing out. We finally found the cutoff, so here for a little bit, the water will be off, and I just wanted you to know that. On the other side, as I look at water anytime flowing out of the church, I think of that vision that Ezekiel had. You remember that vision that Ezekiel had? When God took him to the temple and brought him up, and there was just a little stream flowing out of the temple, and the stream got a little bit wider and a little bit deeper and a little bit wider and a little bit deeper, and it flowed into the Dead Sea. It became this massive river, and everything around it was living, and it was teeming with life. And he said, that's what God's going to do in my people. And I think, you know what? It's a broken spigot, and water's gushing out. We're familiar with water gushing down the street in Big Spring. But I also think that it speaks to us about who we're to be as the people of God. That the living water of Christ would so fill us and overflow through us that it would run out of us, out into the community, bringing life to those around us. Amen? Amen. So just so you know, water's off. Hopefully we'll get it back on here in a little bit. But if you need to use the restroom or need to get a drink, just be aware that we're taking care of that. We're excited. Our bridge worship team is going to come and lead us in worship, and then we're going to hear what Susie has to share with us tonight. But as we do that, let's just center our hearts and our minds on Christ together. Lord, we're here for you. You are the living water. You said those who come to you and drink from your living water will never be thirsty again. That you would spring up within us this well of living water that never runs dry. And the psalm writer David said, you anoint my head with oil and my cup overflows. That this Spirit of God is so filling me that it just overflows and spills out of my cup into everything else. And God, I pray tonight you would fill us up again. Fill us up so that it's overflowing and spilling out of us. As we worship you, God, as we seek you together tonight, may we just sense the sweetness of your Spirit, the filling of your presence in this place, we pray. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Good evening, everybody. If you guys would like to stand, we're going to worship together tonight. While we get started, I'm going to start with the Word of God. In Psalm 105, it says, "Give thanks to the Lord, call on his name. Make known among the nations what he has done. Sing to him, sing praise to him. Tell of all his wonderful acts. Glory in his holy name. Let the hearts of those who seek the Lord rejoice. Look to the Lord and his strength. Seek his face always. Remember the wonders he has done, his miracles and the judgments he pronounced. O descendants of Abraham, his servant, O sons of Jacob, his chosen ones." And that's talking to us tonight. We're here for him this evening, aren't we? I almost said this morning. It's good to see you all. Let's just worship the Lord together and keep that word on our hearts as we sing to him. You can feel free to clap. I don't deserve grace on top of grace. on top of grace. Amen. Let's sing that again. Lord, how you loved me, I don't deserve grace on top of grace. More than I've asked for, more than I'm worth, grace on top of grace. Grace on top of grace, with your grace on top of grace. How sweet the sound, once lost, now found. Heaven came down and grace rescued me. The sound once lost, now found. Heaven came down and grace rescued me. How sweet the sound once lost, now found. Heaven came down and grace. The cross you took my place, with your grace on top of grace.
Sing it out.
Hallelujah, I am free from my sin and penalty. At the cross you took my place, with your grace on top of grace. With your grace on top of grace. With your grace on top of grace.
Amen. We worship you, Lord.
Our God is great.
greater, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God,
yes, you are, Lord. Our God is for us. Who can be against us? No one. Let's sing it out.
And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand against? And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand against?
Nothing can stand against. Thank you, Jesus.
What can stand against? You are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God, our God. Our God is greater, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God. Our God.
And if our God is for us,
then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand against? And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand against? What can stand against?
Amen. Each one of us should find comfort in that. Thank you, Lord. Let's continue to worship Him. The next song, Lord, I need you. Every hour, I need you. I need you every moment, Lord. I'm desperate for you, Lord.
Holiness
So, Lord, it's not a stretch to say we need you tonight. And, you know, as we prayed before revival, as we prayed before we got started, as the worship team was worshiping, you know, even before that, we prayed and we started talking about what do you expect God to do tonight? That's what we said. Lord, Lord, we want to come in here with some expectations. Not that we can demand anything from you, but you're so good. And we know that you're going to move. And you know that we know that you brought Shelly to us here, Lord, with a word. We know that we want revival. We know that we're praying for your presence. And so, Lord, I just, before we get started, before we start praying, before we really start hearing from you, God, I think we need to just drop the stuff we brought in here and be ready to receive what the Lord has. And maybe, Lord, I need you to move today in this way. I need to hear from you today. Lord, we prayed for breakthrough before you guys got here. Lord, we need you to break through. And so to receive that today, you might have to drop something that you brought in here. You might have to clear some space in your mind. You might have to clear some space in your heart, and the Lord wants to take it today. So I don't know what that means to you, but as we start praying, make room. Expect the Lord to move. So God, today, we need you. We pray that you would move in a mighty way, God. Those little things like the water and all this stuff, it's not going to stop us, God, and it certainly doesn't stop you. So, Lord, we pray past technological stuff. We pray past the water. We pray that we can have an open heart and an open mind to receive the word that you have for us today. Lord, you might have already started messing us up with the word this morning to the ladies in our service last night. God, you've already started to move. And you might be just, we might have walked in here a little messed up from last night. But you are not done. And there might be some things, God, that we need to drop. Some things that you're calling us to put behind, God. Some ways that we need to step out. Lord, we give you room to do that today. In our hearts and minds, God. We love you and we praise your name. Let your spirit fall in this place even more. Let hearts and minds be open and ready to receive, Lord. Let us be a church ready for some breakthrough. In Jesus' name, amen.
Well, when I was a little girl, I was
gently call me into your presence, guiding me by your Holy Spirit. Teach me, dear Lord, to live all of my life through your eyes. I'm captured by take me.
good to be reminded tonight that he can purify us of all unrighteousness and all sin. There's nothing too dirty that he can't make worthy. Let's pray together. Lord, we thank you for the reminder tonight. It's so easy for us to find ourselves crawling into a cave, trying to hide out from all the stuff we don't want to face, God. All the things that are overwhelming us in life and overwhelming us in the world, oh God. And just, we feel overwhelmed, and so it's so easy for us to find ourselves just crawling into a dark cave, saying, I'm done. I don't want to deal with it anymore. I don't want to see it anymore. I'm just done, God. I'm done. Lord, I thank you that even when we are done, you're not done with us. And I thank you, Father, that even in the darkest parts of our life, when we've crawled into the cave, you still speak to us. God, I thank you that you go into the depths of the cave after us to call us out and to bring us back into your light. So, Lord, I just pray that we would receive that word tonight, that we truly would come out of the cave, out of darkness, and into your wonderful light. Lord, help us not to just come out of the darkness and into the light tonight, but help us to be children of the light, who walk in the light, who live in the light, that your light would be on us and shine through us, and that we would shine so bright that as we go out into the community, as we go out to our family, as we go out into the world, people would be just blinded by the light of God that is in us. Because you're in us, God. We love you, Lord. Fill us again and use us for your purposes, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen. You've been encouraged tonight. That was pretty weak. Have you been encouraged tonight? Yeah. Amen. Well, come back tomorrow morning at 9 a.m. We're going to have a time of Bible study. Invite your friends, neighbors, others to come join us. Great time of worship at 10 o'clock. Closing out this spiritual deepening service. We love you. Love you all. God loves you more. Go in his grace and peace tonight.